There's anger and frustration throughout Northam tonight, with five asylum seekers still on the run after escaping from the town's detention centre. Locals say authorities are keeping them in the dark. Rebecca Johns reports.
It's been almost 48 hours since the detainees escaped from the Yonga Hill Detention Centre. They still haven't been found.
The fact that they're out and about is a degree of risk from anybody's perspective, so there are concerns that the longer they stay out, the greater the risk may be.
The five Vietnamese asylum seekers fled the centre about 7:30 on Saturday night after scaling this 3-metre-high electric fence. Police spent today and yesterday searching for the men using infrared cameras throughout the night. Locals say despite the extensive efforts to find the men, they're angry they weren't told about the escape straight away.
I don't feel really safe. I've got kids and I've got my wife at home. Yeah, I don't feel real safe at all.
I think it's disgusting considering it's supposed to be escape-proof, but what can one do?
Police say just before 9 o'clock last night, two of the detainees went to a house in central Northam asking for food. It's understood the resident offered them something to eat before calling police. The men then fled on foot. Police have also found food containers under railway lines where they believe the pair have been hiding. The Northam Shire says they're concerned authorities are yet to notify locals of the escape.
Pretty disappointed, yeah, because the fact that these guys pose no threat is fine, but what happens if they were people that did pose a threat?
The state government says it's not impressed with the lack of information.
Who is it that has to go out and look for the escapees? The West Australian Police. And that's what the Commonwealth continually ignores.
A meeting will be held here on Thursday with the Department of Immigration at Serco and community representatives. They're set to discuss what went wrong and what's going to be done to fix the problem.
Rebecca Johns, 10 News.